this month's Nature's Calling. I'm Lucas Bond with the Missouri Department of Conservation. It's a great time of year to be outside discovering nature by fishing. Once you're through fishing, be sure not to dump your leftover bait into the water because it can spread invasive species, like certain types of carp. Invasive bighead and silver carp have become an aggressive nuisance in our natural waters. Silver carp are known for leaping in the air when startled by boat motors. This invasive species can be dangerous for boaters when driving or riding in boats. Bighead and silver carp are plankton feeders and they deplete food used by native sport fish such as bass and crappie. However, their meat is delicious and many anglers enjoy it cooked many ways. One way anglers can help stop the spread of these invasive carp is to be sure the live bait they're using is not bighead or silver carp, which can look just like gizzard shad. While you're out on the water enjoying yourself this summer, something you need to be on the lookout for are invasive zebra mussels. This thumbnail-sized mussel from Eurasia can be found in lakes and streams in more than 25 Missouri counties. Zebra mussels are highly destructive. They alter the ecology of waters they infest by competing with native fish and other animals for food, clog water intakes, and cause millions of dollars of damage to boats, docks, and other property.
Boaters can do three simple steps: clean, drain, and dry. So clean their boats, make sure there's no mud or debris or anything attached to it. Drain any residual water out of the boat from live wells or cooling systems, things of that nature. And then also let it dry in the hot sun for 3 to 5 days if possible, and that will help to prevent the spread of zebra mussels.
Don't move a mussel and be sure to clean your boat and gear thoroughly between trips. Another aquatic invasive species you need to be aware of is hydrilla. Hydrilla is a weed that can harm our aquatic resources. It chokes out local aquatic plant communities, interferes with boating and fishing, clogs water intake systems, and changes the dynamics of fish populations. Hydrilla is a submerged aquatic plant that was introduced to the United States in the early 1950s, more than likely through the aquarium trade. More than 30 states, including Missouri, are dealing with this invasive species. Hydrilla is very hard to eradicate once it's found. The best option is preventing the invasive aquatic plant from spreading.
Preventing the spread of hydrilla includes never dumping aquariums in outside water bodies. And then for those of us who play outside in the water, it includes clean, drain, and dry. Clean boats and gear. Motorized and non-motorized boats, fishing gear, any recreational items. Drain any water that's trapped in them before you leave, and then make sure that they are dry before you go recreate in another water body.
For more information on invasive carp, zebra mussels, and hydrilla, visit mdc.mo.gov. Thanks for watching, and remember, nature's calling. Get out and enjoy Missouri's outdoors.